everyone, this is Amruta. Welcome to my channel. So today in this video, we are going to plan 2020. So what is planning and why it is so important? Is it sounds like a lecture? No, chill guys. I'm not going to take any lecture. I'm just here to share my experiences. So I'm a freelancing Zumba instructor and I have a studio. So I have to take classes in different places. And in my studio also classes will happen. So I have to keep track of everything. What time is the class and when it is happening and which place. So it clash everything in my mind. So I can't keep track of it and sometimes I forget classes. Then I started writing the next day's schedule in a notebook so that the day before I can just refer and follow it. But my husband says, why don't you use the Google Calendar and you know stuff like that and some apps are there. But I'm not a techie to follow all these things and I don't know why I don't like those stuffs. I like all this, you know, stationery and this cute stuff. So I just want to write everything in my notebook. So in 2019, I used this Alessia D'Souza's planner. It is pretty good. So for 2020, I used this Your Fantastic Life and Business workbook by Shreya Sharan Pava. So it is a planner come a workbook. I really loved it. So I just use only for my studio and business related things. And my personal and YouTube related things, I use a separate one, which I am going to show you right now. And actually some people who wants to start the planning don't want to spend money on buying these planners. I have a cool way for you guys. I came across this book called Bullet Journaling Method by Ryder Carroll. According to him, bullet journaling is track your past, order your present and design your future. So let's see how I start bullet journaling.
Don't let your dreams be dreams. So let's plan together. For bullet journaling, all you need is a book and a pen. This is the cover page for all your details. And here is the index. Here is the first page of my bullet journal, which is key page. This is all about the symbols and their meanings, which are used in this bullet journal. You need not to draw anything like this sort. You can just simply write key as a heading of the page and continue writing the symbols and their meanings. I just do it because it gives me the motivation to come back and write in this cute book, which is completely my personal choice. I use Pinterest to get the inspiration for the layout of the page and the designs. Here I am using a dotted notebook and a black gel pen. You can use any notebook,
white, rule or grid. Here I am giving one small square for the task and when it is completed I can tick it up. If it is cancelled I can cross it. You can give any symbols of your choice. And here is a cover page of my journal.
There is a quote page. I really believe in new beginnings. So I just wrote the quote, trust the magic of new beginnings. I doesn't know how to do calligraphy. Don't judge me on that. All you have to remember is it's your journal. So make it the way you like it. I actually wrote everything with pencil first and then I'm going on it with a pen.
This quote page is completely optional. Just for motivation, I'm adding this.
The next piece is all about my 20 goals before 2020. I separate my goals into four categories: career, personal, family, and financial goals. This is the overview of 6 months. I have separated one page into three equal parts for 3 months so that I can see the 6 months at a glance. In this, you can write all the important events or your achievements and stuff like that. What I personally do is break down my goals, which I mentioned in my goal page, and break down them into actionable items for each month to achieve them easily. So here I am writing the calendar view of every month like this, just to make it simple and easy to access. Here comes my bucket list page. You might think, what is a goal and what is a bucket list? According to me, goals are like mostly related to career, finance, personality development. Achieving them will be a biggest thing for us. Bucket list things are mostly dreams, which you wanted to do for your inner self. Like scuba diving. And for this year, my bucket list is going on a solo trip. Already my husband is laughing at me. Let's see what happens. This year I want to read at least 10 books. So I'm adding this page to remind me all the time whenever I open this page. I just draw this simple doodle of stack of books where I can write the name of the book I want to read in this year. All these extra designs you can totally skip. Again, I just do it for myself just to make it look cute. Here comes my favorite page, which is all about traveling, places to travel. Added this quote, "We travel not to escape life, but for life not to escape us." Luckily, me and my husband both loves to travel. Whenever we want to celebrate an occasion like birthdays and anniversaries, we just travel together. Because traveling is a celebration for us. This year, I'm planning to vlog my travel. Recently, we have visited Thailand and Hampi. If you want to see those vlogs, please consider subscribing my channel. In this year, at least I want to visit 8 places. So I made 8 boxes. Whenever I finish traveling to these places, I just color them up. This is for all the ideas of YouTube and Instagram. Whenever I get an idea, I can just write it down here. Here I am doodling a bulb just to indicate ideas. This is year in a pixel page. This helps to track all your moods for each day for the entire year. At any time, you can refer and track how many days you are productive, when you are happy, when you are feeling lazy, and things like that so that you can plan to improve upon. At the end of the day, I fill the grid with the color of emotion or mood. So let's see the final output. These are the contents and the page numbers. This is the key page. And this is the cover page. After coloring it, this looks so pretty, isn't it? So this is the quote. And these are my goals. And this is the 6 months overview. And bucket list page and the books to read. And the places to travel page. Here I've already visited Hampi, so I colored it up. And the brain dump page and the year in pixels. I just colored few of them. So here I pasted this washi tape just to act as a bookmark. I can easily open it and it keeps on reminding me.
Now we all know how to set up a yearly bullet journal. And in those things, if you wanted to skip any page, you can skip according to your needs. If you wanted to add more, you can add. Like, you don't read books, then you can skip that page. Instead of that, if you wanted to add this, if you are watching the Netflix series a lot, you can add the series to watch instead of the books to read. So you can add according and change according to your needs. In my next video, we are going to see how we have to set up a monthly bullet journal. If you have any queries in this, please mention them in the comment section below. I would love to reply to them. Hope this video helps you in planning your 2020. If you like this video, please consider subscribing to my channel. For more interesting content on planning, organizing, travel, shopping, lifestyle and many more. Like and share this video to show us some love. One last word. Planning is not a process which you do at the beginning of the year. You can do it any time of the year. But remember, that is the starting stage of your success. See you all guys in my next video. Happy planning!